Laudetur Jesus Christus, and welcome to the Angelus celebrated on this 10th Sunday of Ordinary Time here in St. Peter's Square in Rome, where thousands of pilgrims are waiting to pray this midday prayer with Pope Francis and to hear his reflection on today's Gospel reading. I would like to welcome all of you who are joining us through Catholic TV, EWTN, Shalom World TV, as well as all of you who are joining us throughout the world through various Vatican media outlets. It is my pleasure to provide this English language commentary for you. My name is Sister Bernadette Reese. Here now, we with the pilgrims are focusing on that window where very shortly His Holiness Pope Francis will emerge in order to greet the crowds gathered here on this beautiful Sunday morning in Rome. Some of these pilgrims have been in the square for hours, many of them coming from different parts of the world. And we join with our brothers and sisters now. We can hear the crowds expectantly waiting for our Holy Father. Of course, one of the highlights of anyone who comes to Rome is to be able to gather with our Holy Father on Sundays in order to recall the event of events, the Incarnation, and to participate in the joy of the Heavenly Father as through the angel Gabriel he announces the birth of his Son. And here now, the Holy Father emerges and greets the crowds.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, good morning.
Di questa domenica ci mostra due tipi di incomprensione che Gesù ha dovuto affrontare.
This Sunday's Gospel shows us two types of misunderstanding that Jesus had to face, that of the scribes and that of his own family members.
La prima incomprensione.
The first.
Gli scribi erano uomini istruiti nella legge e nelle sacre scritture.
The scribes were men instructed in the law and the holy scriptures and charged with explaining them to the people. Some of them were sent from Jerusalem to Galilee, where Jesus' fame was beginning to spread, in order to discredit him in the eyes of the people, in order to do what gossips do, to tear down the other, to take away his authority. This is something ugly, and they were sent to do this.
E questi scribi arrivano con un'accusa precisa e terribile.
These scribes arrive with a precise and terrible accusation. They went right to the heart. And they said this: he is possessed by Beelzebul and by the prince of demons drives out demons. So it's the head of the demons that he works. So it's the same as saying that Jesus was possessed by a devil. In fact, Jesus healed many sick people. And they wanted to make them believe that he did not do it with the Spirit of God, as he was doing, but with the spirit of the evil one, with the force of the devil. Jesus reacts with strong and clear words. He does not tolerate this, because those scribes, perhaps without realizing it, were falling into the most serious sin, denying and blaspheming against the love of God, present and at work in Jesus. Blasphemy. It is the sin against the Holy Spirit. It's the only unforgivable sin. That's what Jesus said. Because it starts from a heart closed to the mercy of God acting in Jesus.
Questo episodio contiene un ammonimento che serve a tutti noi.
This episode contains a warning that's useful for all of us. In fact, sometimes a strong envy for a person's goodness and good works can lead to falsely accusing him or her.
La malizia con cui in modo premeditato.
This is deadly poison here. It's the premeditated malice with which one wants to destroy the good reputation of another person. May God keep us from this terrible temptation. And if in examining our conscience we realize that this evil weed is sprouting within us, we should go right away to confess it in the sacrament of penance before it develops and produces its evil effects, because they're incurable. Be careful.
Questo atteggiamento distrugge le famiglie, le amicizie, le comunità.
This behavior destroys families, even friendships and society.
L'Evangelo di oggi ci parla anche di un'altra incomprensione.
Today's Gospel also speaks to us of another very different misunderstanding that Jesus had to face, that of his family. They were worried because his new itinerant life seemed crazy to them. In fact, he was so available to the people, especially to the sick and sinners, that he no longer even had time to eat. Jesus was like that. First the people, serving the people, helping the people, teaching the people, everything for the people. He didn't have time even to eat. His family decided to take him back to Nazareth, back home. They came to the place where Jesus was preaching and sent someone to call him. And he was told, your mother and your brothers and your sisters are outside asking for you. And he answers, who are my mother and my brothers? And looking at the people around him who were listening to him, he adds, here are my mother and my brothers, for whoever does the will of God is my brother and sister and mother.
Non più basata sui legami naturali.
Jesus formed a new family, no longer based on natural bonds, but on faith in him and on his love that welcomes us and unites us to one another in the Holy Spirit. All those who accept Jesus' word are children of God and brothers and sisters to one another. Welcoming the word of Jesus makes us brothers and sisters among us. It makes us the family of Jesus. Speaking badly of others, destroying the reputation of others, makes us part of the devil's family. Jesus' response is not a lack of respect for his mother and his family. Indeed, it is the greatest recognition for Mary, because she herself is the perfect disciple who obeyed God's will in everything. May the Virgin Mary help us to live always in communion with Jesus, recognizing the work of the Holy Spirit, who acts in him and in the church and regenerates the world into new life.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mihi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, grazia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitrix.
Ut digni officiam et promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam quaesum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, ut qui angelo annunciante, Christi Fili tui, incarnationem coniovim, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrectionis gloriam perducamur, per eum in Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sic ut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua in luce Teis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunque est, quae in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Amen.
The crowd reacting now to having received the Holy Father's blessing.
Cari fratelli e sorelle.
Dear brothers and sisters.
Desidero nuovamente far giungere.
I would like once again to remember or to tell the people of Korea that I'm praying for them and the talks that will happen in the next few days in Singapore that may develop something positive, a future of peace for the Korean Peninsula and for the entire world. For this, we pray to the Lord. And let's say all together, we pray that Our Lady of Korea might accompany these talks.
Tu sei benedetta fra le donne e benedetto il frutto del tuo seno, Gesù. Santa Maria, Madre di Dio, prega per noi peccatori, adesso e nell'ora della nostra morte. Amen. Oggi ad Agen in Francia viene proclamata beata Suor Maria della Concezione.
Today in Agen, France, the beatification of Sister Mary of the Conception will take place, who was born, her birth name was Adelaide de Batz de Tranquilleon. She lived between the 18th and 19th centuries and founded the Daughters of Mary Immaculate, who are known as the Marianists. We praise the Lord for his daughter, who consecrated her life to him and to the service of her brothers and sisters, and he's asking the crowds to applaud for this new blessed.
Saluto tutti voi, cari romani e pellegrini.
I greet all of you, dear Romans and pilgrims, parish groups, families, associations. In particular, I greet the Spanish faithful.
Da Murcia, Pamplona e Logroño.
I've come from Murcia, Pamplona and Logroño.
E dall'Italia.
And those from Italy, from Naples, the young people of Mestrino, and an alpine sports group of Legnano. I wish all of you a blessed Sunday. Please don't forget to pray for me. Have a good lunch and goodbye. And so our Holy Father concludes his greeting to the people in gathered in St. Peter's Square, having received his blessing, and all of you joining via whatever form of communication, also having received his blessing, let us remember to pray for him today, as well as to remember Korea, the intention that our Holy Father has given us today. Shortly available on the Vatican News website, you will find a summary of the Angelus. Thank you all for joining us today. May your Sunday truly be blessed. For all of us here at Vatican Media, Laudetur Jesus Christus.